Yes, madam. My study is on out-of-pocket expenditure incurred among adult dengue patients in Colombo district. In Sri Lanka, dengue infection is a major public health concern, which is currently hindered by the COVID-19 pandemic. Information regarding costing of an illness is important in deciding the suitable price of interventions in the diagnosis and management, as well as to estimate funds for health policies. The objective was to assess the household cost borne by an adult in a household confirmed and admitted with dengue infection in Colombo district. The household costs are the expenses borne by the patient and his family due to the hospitalization of the patient with dengue illness. There are two broad categories, direct costs and indirect costs. A longitudinal study was conducted in the Institute of Infectious Diseases in Colombo district from July 2018 to December 2018. Study population consisted of adults aged 18 to 60 years confirmed with dengue infection, patients who were transported from another hospital having a mental illness, and pregnant mothers and who were unable to comprehend in Sinhala language were excluded. 50 patients, each from dengue fever and dengue hemorrhagic fever categories, were enrolled adopting systematic sampling. Patients were interviewed on the date of discharge from the hospital and were followed up for 2 weeks. Administrative and ethical clearance was obtained. The household costs were calculated for 3 phases: ambulatory cost, cost incurred during hospitalization, and post-hospitalization cost. Cost components were presented using mean, standard deviation, median, and interquartile range. The costs were calculated using actual cost by Sri Lankan rupees and converted to US dollars. Results. Majority of participants were within age of 36 to 60 age category among dengue fever patients, and among dengue hemorrhagic fever patients, majority were within 18 to 35 years, majority composed of males. The average household cost among dengue fever patients was $127 US, and among dengue hemorrhagic fever patients, it was $134 US. In both dengue fever and dengue hemorrhagic fever categories, direct cost composed of the majority. Considering direct costs in both categories, investigation costs were reported as zero during hospitalization period. More than 50% of expenses as indirect costs had occurred during the post-hospitalization period. More than 50% of patients had to take no pay leave in both categories, and the average number of work days lost by patients due to this illness episode among both categories was approximately 10 days. In both categories, 18% were having protection from an insurance scheme, yet only 1% had applied for compensation. The out-of-pocket expenditure consisted of 98% of total costs incurred by dengue fever patients, and among dengue hemorrhagic fever patients, it was accounted to 95.95%. According to statistics from the Department of Census and Statistics in 2016, the average monthly income of a household in Colombo district was $571 US, and therefore nearly 25% of a family monthly income was spent from a household if a single adult was hospitalized with dengue illness. Conclusions and recommendations. The out-of-pocket expenditure is high once a dengue patient is receiving institutional care. This is a very significant finding since Sri Lanka is in the backdrop of reaching universal health coverage. Strengthening the dengue control program is the key towards reducing out-of-pocket expenditure and achieving universal health coverage. I should acknowledge the authors. I am grateful to the University of Sri Jayawardena for the financial support, and also to my supervisors, colleagues, and the patients who gave an immense support. Thank you.